Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you are doing well at home. Welcome back to my class. As you all know that we are revising SAT syllabus. So let us revise today 6th lesson, The Lost Camel. So children, take out page number 74. So in this lesson, there are three scenes. Now let us see, this story is about a greedy and foolish king who sends away his wise ministers from the kingdom. Now, does he realize his mistake? Let us find out. So, scene 1, the king's court. The ministers are seated and waiting for the king. The king enters and the ministers stand up. The king excitedly, nothing but happily and eagerly, he said, our neighbor, the king of Pachu, he is building a grand palace and I want it to make better than him. So because of that, I need money and men to build a new palace for me. So tell me, how can I collect more money from the people? Then the ministers looked at each other. And then the first minister said, your majesty, people are mostly farmers and they are unable to give you more money. So they'll suffer if they pay money. Then the third minister said, this is the season of ploughing and sowing and the farmers are very busy, so they cannot leave their lands. Then second minister said, this is a fine palace and why do you build the new palace same as the king of Pachu? So the king got angered and angrily he said, you are being disrespectful. If you cannot get me what I want, I shall rule without you and you can go out from my kingdom. Then the ministers are very sad and they left the court. In the scene 2, as they were out of the kingdom, the ministers, they are walking on a sandy road leading out of the city and they notice a camel's hoof marks, footprints, right? So the second minister said, look, a camel has gone ahead of us on the road. Then from that other side, a man comes along of the road and he looks very unhappy. Then the man said, have you seen a camel anywhere? I have lost my camel. Then the third minister said, is your camel lame in one leg? Then the man said, yes, he is. The second minister said, is your camel blind in one eye? Yes, yes, he is, the man said. Then the first minister said, was your camel carrying a load of honey and wheat? Yes, the man was very happy. So he said, yes, that's my camel. So where did you see him? Then the third minister said, we haven't seen your camel. Then the man got very angered and angrily he said, you know as much about my camel as I do and yet you say you have never seen him? I did not believe you. If you don't give my camel back, I'll tell to the king. So the first minister said, okay, we will also come with you. In the scene 3, so the man came along with the three ministers and they appeared near the king. The man said, your majesty, please help me. These three men have stolen my camel and they are not giving me back. Then the king said, what do you say that? The man said, so they know everything about my camel. They know that my camel is blind. He is lame with one leg and he was carrying honey and wheat. So yet they are saying that they have never seen him and do not know where he is. Then the first minister said, yes, it is true, your majesty. We have not seen this man's camel. The king said, you should be ashamed of yourself for telling such lies. The king scolded to the ministers. And how can you know so much about the camel? Then the first minister starts saying the story. We are speaking the truth, majesty. We have not seen the camel. Just we will be explaining you how we have guessed the camel. So second minister said, so as we were walking along the road, we noticed several things such as camel's hoof on the road, and he was carrying always the marks are very clear, but the fourth was not. So we could tell that camel was limped and he was lame with one leg. Then the third minister said, the leaves of trees on one side of the road had been nibbled. Nibbled is nothing but taken small bite, ate something in a small bite. So who ate here? The camel. He ate, and that was eaten by the tall animal. So we have guessed that it was camel, and he was blind with one eye. Then the first minister said, thirdly, there were many flies on one side of the road and a few grains of wheat on the other. So we thought that the camel must have been carrying honey and wheat. Then the king said to the man, yes, they are saying very true. They are very true, wise persons, and they are very clever also. They have not seen your camel. So you have to look your camel by yourself. The king turns to the three wise men, and he said that, I will reward you and I will not punish you, but please stay in my court and please help me rule my people wisely and well. So I cannot lose such wise men, he said to the ministers. So the ministers stayed in the king court. Now let us see question answers. So this bit is not necessary, children. No need to learn this bit. Read these lines. If you can't get me what I want, I shall rule without you. So who said these words to whom? Yes, the king said these words to three ministers. And why did he say them? Because they told him that he did not need a new palace. I did not believe you. Who said these words to whom? The camel owner said these to the three ministers. And why did he say them? Because the three ministers described the camel very well. So that's why he said that he did not believe them. Next, third one. You should be ashamed of yourself for telling such lies. Who said these words to whom? Yes, the king said to the three ministers. And were they telling lies? No, they were not telling lies. They are saying true. Okay, C, D and E bit is not necessary, children. See here the simple present tense. Simple present tense definition is something which is happening now, that are always true, and something that happens again and again. Okay, it is an action. It is used to talk about an action that is over. This is the past tense. Okay, so for the past tense, we will be adding ed to the given verbs. So few words are here, packed. Okay, next is cleaned. So whatever ed words are there, that are simple past. Okay, simple present is nothing but I do my homework in the evening. Next is Zubin and Anita play the piano. Nita eats almond every day. Okay, next. Here past tense of go, went, sit, sat, buy, bought, take, took, tell, told, lose, lost. Okay, let us see here helping verbs. Helping verbs, you just remember the examples, children. Am, was, is, are, were. These are the examples of helping verbs. I am writing a letter. Am is helping verb. Rita was having her dinner. Was is helping verb. In the same way, the next one. Alright, so till here we will stop, children. Next to see here poem, thousands and thousands of grains, thousands and thousands of stars in the sky. There are many thousands of stars in the sky, mountains, hills, birds are flying in the sky, the blades of grass, fishes in the seas, pretty flowers and trees. So there are lots of animals, birds in the world. So this poem is about thousands and thousands. Okay, so no need to learn the question answers part. That's all for today, children. With this we have completed 6th lesson and this poem. Take care. Bye bye.